Unsustainable agricultural practices continue to threaten wetlands daily. Despite numerous efforts and campaigns by the government to end encroachment and restore degraded wetlands. Uganda will join the rest of the world to celebrate World Wetlands Day this Friday, denoting the date of the selection of the Convention on Wetlands on February 2, 1971, under the theme Wetlands and Human Wellbeing at Kaunda Grounds in Gulu City. Samuel Cheptoris, the Minister of Water and Environment, has emphasized that wetland conservation is not government's sole responsibility. He implored leaders and the general public to join the government in all her efforts to protect and conserve wetlands in Uganda.
We witness encroachment almost on a daily basis. But you know, the mistake sometimes we make is to think that the issue of protection of wetlands is the responsibility of one institution. The issue of environment should be the concern of all of us, of every individual.
Minister Cheptoris has issued a warning to the wetland encroachers, emphasizing that all those found culpable will face the law.
So we don't tolerate impunity. We don't tolerate impunity. We do whatever we can to ensure that the wetlands are protected. In any case, if His Excellency the President himself can give us support, who are these other people? Who else is bigger than the President? Are there people who are bigger than the President? Of course, no. So for us, we have the power of the President behind us. So anybody else, we shall crush. So I'm asking my technical people here, please.
Also, the government under the National Environmental Management Authority, NEMA, is set to recruit 2,000 personnel on the Environment Protection Force.
NEMA, one of the areas of reform, is establishment of a dedicated force for enforcement of environmental laws. So the Environment Protection Force has been formed. Initial personnel of now, we are at around 120, have been already recruited. They are going for training. We are working with the Uganda Police Force to finalize the curriculum.
This year's theme, Wetlands and Human Wellbeing, underscores the critical need for human stewardship of the world's wetlands, since wetlands and people are life interlaced. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.